Able to?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So I uploaded this yesterday. Tua, just for
Yes, sir.
recap, register addressing, direct addressing, we have done with indirect addressing, immediate addressing. Okay, so some of you must be wondering what is this DBTR? This DBTR is a data pointer register. Okay, it's only one, there is only one data pointer register in 8051, and that is DBTR. So data pointer, we'll see why is this data pointer. Okay, and out of this, see, one is this, and this is the simple, remember, register, direct, delay, immediate addressing. These three are simple, but the third one, indirect addressing mode, I mean the fourth one, this is little bit confusing. So I'll start with from here. Okay. So, any how on the look slow index and addressing how on the low, you need to understand this indirect addressing. So again, I'll tell you once more. This indirect addressing is assigning the address indirectly, okay, using these three registers, R0, R1, DPTR. These three registers will use, see, only these three may, if the address of the operand is specified indirectly by the register, then instruction have indirect addressing. Like for example, see, at the rate RP, this is register pair, okay, RP, because to make it 16 bit benidellu and a register pair, then zonu two registers they have made into one. Okay, at A comma at the rate RP, this is one example. Why is this at the rate here? What did you understood? At the rate. What is the meaning of this? Second one, move A comma at the rate RP. What do you understand by this one? Move A comma at the rate RP. Can someone tell me? Value of RP becomes the address. RP the hema assigned baby home the value chimo. Any register pair register the any value the hema any hema assigned number to assign baby home birthday. Any number the that becomes the address. Agwiga. And for example, see here. Any value of, let's say, I write a move, okay, move R1 comma, can you see that? Move R1 comma hash 200 20H. What did you understood from here? What do you understand by this code? The value 20H is transferred into R1. And Jindisu, are you getting what I'm saying here? Jindisu.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes,
And you
sir.
take a look, halamji. Now, if I write move, okay. Move A comma at the rate R1 divachin, R1 divachin. What do you understand? here moving the value, remember the moving the value, okay, this one is moving the value, may moving the value 20h, remember the mush 22 R1, remember the mush address jinji remember the anidi. But what about this one? Now R1 becomes your pointer here. So whatever value which is in pointed in R1, pointed by R1, will be transferred to A. Whatever value which is in location 20. Now 20 the that's a value chamchi deva any time nadi. Now 20 becomes your address here. Okay. So what we are doing is we are moving the value indirectly, which value we don't know. We don't know. 20H is not a value in this one. What kind of addressing mode is this? This one. This one. What kind of addressing mode is this? First line.
Limited address mode.
Index addressing mode. Is it index addressing mode, Ani?
Immediate
addressing. This is immediate addressing because there is an immediate value here. Are you getting? This is an immediate value. But this one is indirect addressing mode because you are moving a value indirectly. Okay. Which is in 20H. But 20H, it's not shown here. Where is the address? The Mila, that address is pointed by R1. Are you getting? So with this line the meaning will be moving the value in location is actually 20H, which is pointed by R1 to accumulator. Agwega, this is the meaning, and this one is your Agwega. Did you understood with these two line? Now whatever value in this first line, in this line 20H was the value, but now with this 20H is not your value. Now this is your address, which is pointed by R1. Agwega. Now if I write here X, analo X divachinana. Okay. If I write here X, is it visible here? X thoingana. And X divachindi, it will become external data. External RAM. Okay, you are moving the value from external RAM. If I don't write this is internal RAM. This is internal RAM. But if I write X here, this is from external RAM. From external RAM, I'm bringing the data. We have extended RAM. Do you know external RAM? Say how much it is external RAM? Internal RAM, external RAM, internal ROM, external ROM. Say, you should see that 65,500. 65,000 bytes. External RAM. Yeah. Because that much can be extended. That is your external RAM. Okay. So you are bringing from outside any external device, external peripheral. This is you, when you write X, you're not moving the value within the microcontroller. You're bringing the value which from outside, external, extended RAM to inside, which is in accumulator. Accumulator is inside your microcontroller, right? Are you getting? So this is your, what is that? Indirect addressing mode. Now, if I go back to the screen, if you don't see, please let me know. Okay, So see, and a move X, A, this is also one example of indirect addressing, but X stands for external memory. I have written here clearly. See, whatever value which is in external memory will be pointed by DPTR. In this case, DPTR is a pointer. Okay. In this case, DPTR is a pointer. And that value which is pointed by DPTR, okay, will be moved to A. That address is pointed by DPTR. That particular address is pointed by your DPTR, okay, during that time. We'll know what is this DPTR in a while. Ani index taudalu. Hagwega. DPTR is also another special function register, SFR, which is used to point the location, okay? Pointer, it acts like a pointer. Now with this concept, let's go to your, now in the back of all this programming, code memory gear, location is being used, may code memory na RAM the ROM nichara and allocate jodebate. You remember, right? I told you last time also. Okay, where is that indirect addressing? Like, for example, let's say this one. Move A, comma, at the rate R naught. Only one byte cycle. One with one byte cycle, it means that to save this, we need only one memory location. So the let's say the opcode is E6. E6 will occupy one of the location. Ani ki location omade ani address di. Direct chegi device in the mitwa. Location, then only this code will be saved, right? This whole code will be saved in one of the location. That location is happening in ROM, okay? That is your program memory. What code? That any this program will not be saved as this program. This program will be saved in the form of opcode. Opcode. This opcode will occupy one memory location that is given by this is the random number they have chosen, 0202 name. Actually, there should be 0202, then this one. Are you getting? The opcode of this one will be occupied here. See, this is not E6, but this is E6 actually. This is E6. This should be E6. There is a mistake here. This is happening in ROM. The one which I said, all the operation are not being the address pointed by are not selectimena. These all things are happening in RAM. So you need to understand both what is happening in ROM and what is happening in RAM. Are you getting or not? Is it clear? Now here, tame analu are not selabdalu. Are not can be in any bank, right? R naught can be in any bank. R naught which bank? Register bank 0 na A, register bank 1 na A, register bank 2 na A. Because every bank will have R0, R1, R2, R3, R4. Imemena. Is it true or not? Every bank will have R0, R2, R3, R4, R5, R6, and R7. But the value which is I want to transfer is in the address which is pointed by R0. Are you getting or not? So let's say, see here in the register bank. I'll show it this whiteboarded away. Let's say this is RAM. The ROM give any this shego me chegi. ROM the I won't tell, okay? ROM. You understood, right? If this one is 0202, like for example, let's say this one is 0202 location imagine. Okay. 0202 nalu in the ROM. 0202 location will be occupied with the opcode of this value. Hagoega of this value. Are you talking about this one, right? Opcode of 0202. I don't want now this one. Move a comma at the rate r not t. This one 0202 colon this one, right? What does this mean? This means that only one memory location, that this memory location is being occupied in Rome. This, so your program counter will be 0203 because program counter points to the address of the next instruction. Because since this is only 1 byte instruction, this is 1 byte instruction. So your PC will be, your program counter will be 0203. So 0202 nadi anige opcode zoom. Because this is only 1 byte. What is the opcode? E6 in a gamji me mena. But this is happening in Rome, me Rome. Now what is happening in RAM? RAM na. Okay. R naught is assigned with one value. Remember that. Okay. With this R naught, we don't know what is the value. Let's say this is register bank zero. This is register bank zero. Register bank zero na lo R zero. R1, R2, R3, umate. R0, ding alo interested imate. Mosh. R0 is the one which I need here. See, from this value. Memena. From this value, I need R0. So R0 and the value chin imate. Let's say that value is 20H. The value is 20H in R0, which is already assigned in the initial line. Okay. That value has to move to where this 20H value, this is the value, right? Now this value should be your address in this case, right? In this case, 20H is just the value here, but now 20H should be your, what is that? It should be address. So somewhere 20H is somewhere here, let's say. Okay, this one is, let's say 00. Because this is R0 first bank, remember the first any byte the 001, let's say 01. There is 20H. Now 20H location nalu value chain. Are you getting or not? R0 na the 20H zino, but this 20H will be the address now. With this analu, I'll write anigi hemadi and the number me move. Okay, 0201 the move r 0 comma hash 20H, then 0202. No, this one is 200. This one is 2 byte instruction. I need the 2 byte instruction. So that's why 00. Now it will be move a comma at the rate r naught. I need the diagram. RAM. How this is happening? First r naught null 28 zero. R naught. How going to go? Now 20H is your address now. Let's say here the value is 2F inside this. So this value will be moving to your, where it will move? Can someone tell me where it will move?
Accumulator.
Number. This is how you explain. Okay. And continuously this 0200 and 0202 is occupied here in Rome. Rome naya, it's being occupied. But in the RAM, this is how it is happening. First 20 is the R naught na Z. R naught is in register bank 0. It is in 00H location because R naught is the first. Then 20H becomes your address. Let's say in that address, there is one value, that is 2F. And now 2F value will move to accumulator. This is how it's being. I hope you're making notes.
Yes, sir.
So coming back to that diagram. Here. Okay. Okay, so that's what I meant, you know. This is, we are moving the value indirectly, which is being pointed by R naught. Directly R naught use baby member, R naught na assign chi baby, then we are moving. Okay, are getting? So that's why this is indirect. Indirect address mode. Now let's move to index. I hope you are understanding, huh? Index addressing mode, Nadi, you will use a syntax, this syntax. Indirect, Nadi, you are using at the rate to show it how to show indirectly, okay? But in index addressing mode, you will use at the rate a plus dptr, this code, a comma at the rate a plus dptr, Lamidi. At the rate a plus dptr, this code will use more frequently in indirect index addressing. Now let's see some definition here. In index addressing mode, data is accessed from external RAM or on chip ROM. Very important, okay? Anna, either it is external RAM or either it is on chip ROM. It is not internal RAM. Till now, we have been accessing internal RAM. But index addressing is the one. Always between external RAM and on-chip ROM. External RAM, at least it was there in indirect, but on-chip ROM, you know? That means on-chip ROM means it is code memory or data memory? Is it code memory or data memory? Love me. ROM, the ROM. ROM is code memory or data memory? ROM is code memory or data memory?
Code memory, sir.
Code memory, sir.
Code memory, right? Why everybody is silent? All muted.
No, sir. Your voice is reaching late, sir. Network.
Okay. So in index addressing mode, data is accessed from external RAM or on-chip ROM. Very important, okay? This too. Because Shindisudhi, you can bring the data from anywhere, but index you can't bring like that from anywhere. Only two places, that is external RAM and on-chip ROM. This addressing mode is also used when we access the data from lookup table. See, it is widely. We'll go. What is this? We'll see in a while. It is widely used in accessing the data elements of lookup table, which are located in on-chip ROM memory of 8051. Okay. See this. For example, move C a comma at the rate a plus dptr, or move X a comma at the rate dptr. What does this mean? Move C a comma at the rate a plus dptr. With this C, I mean this is code memory. That means this A plus DPTR is happening in ROM or RAM? A plus DPTR address D. Will it be occupied in ROM or RAM?
Rome, sir.
Yes, it will be in Rome because you have written C here. It will not be in A. Dachidi chigi at the rate are not, said Dutalu. It was in RAM. Do you remember? But now you have written C, A plus DPTR will be in Rome.
Rome.
Because this is a code memory now. Move X, A, comma, at the rate. This is in RAM only, but external RAM. You are bringing the data from external RAM to A. Okay. Let's see. I'll again DPH. Okay. I have written a code 0202. Okay. Move A comma at the rate A plus DPTR. Thoinga garegi thoi ani.
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
Yeah. This is example of your indirect index addressing mode. This is your index addressing mode. Okay.
Yes sir.
Move C. C here means it. We are bringing the data from code memory. That is ROM. Okay. Now yes, I'll draw it here, Analu. Tame. Ana, please be attentive. This is important. Index addressing garai lahatani me. Whenever I give this question in exam, students face a lot of problem. Ani index addressing. This is ROM. Please understand this is ROM. This is not RAM now. Everything, what is happening? This is the whole operation is in ROM now because we have written C here. See? ROM nalu 002 the occupied already. 0202. What will be occupied in 0202? Hmm? 0202 nalo, what will be occupied?
Opcode
of which one? Is it visible?
Move.
Is it visible or not?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Opcode of this code. This is 1 byte instruction. So opcode of this code, that is 93H. Okay. Ani opcode di ghadi bhi hoenga di. You don't have to know. There is one table for this. And there is one small calculation, but that calculation is not in your syllabus. And opcode calculation, that is not needed. But you need to understand there will be one opcode for every code. Okay. That, let's say 93. This 93H will be in 0202. And code be the than in 0202. The opcode will be inside this 0202. Let's say that opcode is 93H, which is in 0202. Now, A plus DPTR. Now, DPTR lamidi, DPTR is composed of two things. One is DPH. Okay. One is DPL. Okay, DPH, let's say, so DPH is, this one is 1 byte, this is 1 byte. So when I combine this, this becomes 16 bits, 2 byte. Let's say your value, DPTR is 01FE. Okay. Are you getting? This is your DPTR. This is your DPTR. That means if your 01FE is your DPTR. data pointer. Your DPH is equal to Kachimo and DPL will be equal to Kachimo. Lakshya. Out of this code, which one is DPH?
Zero.
Which one is DPH? Which one is DPL? 01 is a DPH, right? DPL is
FE, sir.
FE, right? FE. Yeah. So DPH is 01. Lower byte, this is up, higher byte. This is lower byte. So 01, this is DPL is FE. So this is how you assign DPTR. So 01 FE location, which is in code memory. So let's say 01 FE is somewhere here. This location, nalu value chidu. We don't know what is that value, okay? Let's say that value is 20H. Okay? Let's say that value is 20H. But now, DPTR samji meme made, but I need also the addition of A here. See, sum of A plus DPTR meme made. So let's say right now your accumulator value is 2. Accumulator nade already assigned chidu bade. Accumulator nalu, let's say 02 assigned dume. Okay. Okay ga? Accumulator nalu 02 assigned already dume. Now I need to add 02 and which one? Which one you'll add?
01 FE.
Yes. 02 plus 01 FE. What is that value? If I add these two now here, 01 FE plus 02. This is actually your DPTR plus A. This is 200H. If you check in your calculator, this is your 200H. Are you getting? So 200H location. Now 01 FE, but 200 location is somewhere up here after two location. This one is 01 FF. This is 01 FF. This one is 200. So in this location, there will be one value. Let's say that value is 30H. Okay,
yes, sir.
This value will be moving to your accumulator now. Confused? Not. Which value will move to accumulator? 20H or 30H?
30H.
30H, not 20H, because 20H is in 01FE. 01FE is just DPTR, but we are moving the value which is in A plus DPTR. A is 02, HEMA. A was 02, HEMA. Now, this 02 plus 01FE, 200. What is in that location? 30H. Now, 30H will be moving to your accumulator. Now, this 02 will be replaced by, this one will be replaced by, I'll 30H. Okay, now this accumulator is in RAM. This is not in ROM. This accumulator is not in ROM. Accumulator is one of the special function registering. You know the location where, you know, ATF. 80FF, 80S le FFS sinji made SFR gidi. When you see that RAM allocation, this only accumulator will be in the RAM. Everything, all the other operation is happening in ROM. That's why you have written here, move C here. Otherwise, dato chinsenga chige ani move bemi value di attara ane abe devade. Do you remember? RAM na samji be devade. Now this is happening in ROM. This is called as index addressing mode. Any questions? Kara silent. Either you have understood everything or either you have not understood anything. So coming back, see, you can check once by your own, okay? Because we have limited. See, there are car notes in Jinji me analu. Please, more notes. If you require more notes, you can again tell me, okay? But this one is more than enough. Analu, number five.
Yes, sir.
This is another example. Is see, move x a comma at the rate is also an but indirect also. Do you remember? Move x a comma at the rate dptr the indirect a devade. So this code can be indirect also. It can be index also. Hagoega? Are you getting? Now, yeah, lookup table. I forgot to tell you about lookup table. Analu. So let's say this one table is given. Okay, I'll draw clear all this. Okay, is it visible, Ani? This is screen.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Let's say you want to display something in LCD. Okay. Hello, this is electrical department. Say display pe gonno ila ani program indi. Okay, hello, analu dinu mo. Hello, yeah, let's see. Each of this alphabet will have some ASCII value. Okay, each of these letter will have ASCII value. ASCII value madhe. This ASCII value will be occupying some location already in your ROM. This is not in RAM, in the ROM, because this is a code memory. Code memory is permanent. I want all this ASCII value to be permanent. Each of this ASCII value, the change me so but the chichamji dhyoma the gati zoru chai. Egi ASCII value, the it will always be one value, right? It starts from 40H, I think. 40, A is I think 40, then it comes 41, 42. Each of this ASCII value will be occupying one space in ROM, permanent memory. Okay, this all these values is permanent. You can't rub any time. You can't erase this. So they will all be in from A to Z. Let's say A to Z, all will be occupied in one memory location. This is universal, permanent. No one can rub this. This is somewhat like in a lookup table. Okay, we call this as lookup table. So whenever I want these values to come up, okay, whenever I want these values later, I will go to this lookup table and I will get the value from there. I'll are you getting or not? So that time you will use a lookup table. This is where you use lookup table to access the data which is already in ROM. This is universal, okay? But what is happening is you have to access the data from lookup table always permanently. That value will never change, remember? So in this kind of scenario also, we'll use index addressing mode. This lookup table is always in ROM. Just I gave you one example, right? LCD screen. Are you getting or not?
Getting, sir.
This is okay. Yeah. So this is index addressing mode. Please remember, move x a array dptr can be index addressing mode also. It can be your also because low indirect addressing models. Any doubt in addressing modes before we go to next topic? Any doubt? Please see this note, okay? And in note nalunga ke I try to explain as much as possible. Ngarangi note ye analu ani Google ki note ye me analu. So with this concept, let's come to this screen now. See, now we know what is immediate, what is registered, what is direct, what is indirect, what is indexed. All this, see every time DPTR will be denoted by DPL and DPH. 4521. This is how you indicate how you assign 4521. Okay. DPTR value. This is how you do. See. Directly go to one example here. If you understand that much, you don't have to go through all this. Kara, same meaning is same. What is the meaning of difference between this one and this one? See, difference between this one and this one. This one and this one. Move A comma 4, the move A comma R4. What is the difference? Meaning gachi moya ani code aniki code. Can you tell me? This one is moving the value which is in location 4H to A. Are you getting? Hello? But this one, what is this one? Moving the value which is in R4 to A. This is register addressing mode. But this one is direct addressing mode. Okay. This is direct addressing. This is register. But R4 cell of the location 4 rahi ho. Because you know in the RAM, what was happening in the RAM? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Imade. Register bank. This is register bank 0. R0, R1, R2, R3, R4. R4 the 4 rahim the location. See? Meaning is same. Do you understand? Meaning is same. May analu. Whatever value is in 20H, move to accumulator low. Let's say this is accumulator. Whatever value which is in 4, this is R4. 4 nahi, R4 ki location. But R4 can be register bank 0, 1 also. R4 can be register bank 1 naya R4 omate analu. 7 chai mo, 7 liana. Firi daru 1, R0, R2. R3, R4. Register bank naya R4 omade. Register bank 2 naya R4 omade. But four is only one location. Are you getting or not? This is a difference between these two code. It looks very simple, but very critical. I hope you are getting. This is very basic. Basic. Tap my arm for 1-2 marks. Difference lab said. Okay. See, analo hash modulation. It is always a location. See, you are moving. This kind of code is also possible. See, special function register. Your direct addressing mode. You can use the location for special function register also. Whenever you use direct addressing mode, it is always all of those SFR or any one of the RAM location. Okay. Are you getting? And yeah, this question is important. Example 5.3. See, Anna, what kind of addressing mode is this?
Indirect.
Indirect addressing mode. So instead of writing like this, I can also write like this. See, if I don't write C, you are moving the value from RAM. This one is RAM, right? You have not written C here. This is indirect or index addressing. This is indirect addressing mode, right? At the rate, this is always C. We can move. What is the meaning of this one? Oh, no. Move at the rate R1, comma B. What is the meaning of this one? This one means moving the value which is in the address pointed by R0 to A. This one, moving the value of B to the address which is pointed by R1. Okay, are you getting? Again, I'll tell you, I am moving the value which is in the address pointed by R0 to A. Meaning of this one. This one, I'm moving the value from B to the address which is pointed by R1. You can use only R0 and R1 like this with the at the rate. We can't use R2, R7. That's what it is written. R2, R7 cannot be used to hold the address of an operand. See, you should know me, Ani. True or false now, only chance me, Ani. Is it true? What is the mistake? Say, please be very vigilant. So, you can try this question. This question is. Ani, after understanding all those register indirect immediate all those addressing modes, then only you will understand this question. See, write a program to copy the value 55H into RAM memory location 40H to 41H. Remember the mush. Copy the value 55H from 55 to 40 to 41. By the way, 55H value the. You need to move from 40 to 41. You need to write this code for this one using register addressing mode, using any and using without loop, with loop. See, there are many techniques. Can someone explain me this one? Yeah. Toto. We'll explain. I'll pick up. Kenzo.
First, we have to move the value 55H into accumulator. Then we have 55H is again moved to 40H, address 40H.
Then? Question the Gachi Mongaji. 55H value the 40 le 41 bagome. 40 location le 41 location na bago, 55H the. First one, A, using direct addressing mode. Okay, then 41 number zora majo de 40 jinse jam se heji de chhi li
sesa
dele tele gachi mode analo ane dot. There is a mistake here. I think this is this is a mistake here. This dot.
Sir, direct on A later quote on S no move to us with the other. Direct and the shift of S to direct quote on S no move to us. Instead of writing
S, yeah. So first, this one is understood. 55 to A, the Zinobadi Mush. Now from A, you're moving the value from A to 40H. So 40H na Hinubadi. Now, why we need this one? 40H to 41H, why we can't write like that? Why we can't write? Why we can't write move 41H, 40H? Can we write like this? Can we write like this? We can't write like this. Of course, the task is from 40 to 41 move behovate. But you check in kill whether this will give error or not. Chachi tada ani kill na. Okay. Kill na chachi ani code diwe 40 ki value di 41 na zunga musica chachi tada ani. Okay. So that's why they have done like this. This is a mistake here. This is not a dot. Okay. So this is how you do with direct addressing mode. Now register addressing mode. Who will explain? Karma Gelsen.
Sir, network is not good at all, sir. I can hear very lately, sir.
It's okay. We can hear you. Try be with any B.
Sir, please show us the question, sir.
B, any 55H value D, you move from 40 to 41. Using register indirect addressing mode. The answer is already given here. Already given, but you need to explain me this one. Can someone explain me how the 55H is moving from 40 to 41 using register addressing mode? That also without loop, see? Without loop. One is with loop, one is without loop. Yeah. Kelzam. She seems to explain. B.
Sir, screen me thumb, sir.
Not there.
No.
We are not seeing the screen, sir.
Yeah. I need to move from 55. I need to move the value 55 from 2. Okay. A came to the addressing mode. That's very simple. Now B, I have to use register indirect addressing mode without loop. Who will explain me this one? Answer is already here, may Analu. How did the value move from 55 from 40 to 41? Yeah, can what somebody explain out of? We'll explain, yeah. Someone from the girl's side, yeah. Sonam. Sonam.
Firstly, moving the value of 55H to accumulator.
Okay.
Then
value of 55, remember, I'm moving the value 55, okay? 55. Value of seller. Yes. Okay, next one.
Then the value 40H to the register R0.
Okay.
Then moving the value of accumulator to the pointer, to the value pointed by the register R0.
To the value
pointed by register R0.
Okay. Now, what is that value which is pointed by R0?
40H.
Address, not the value.
55H.
The value is 55. Now 55D, that is moving to what is the meaning of this one at the rate R0?
That is the value pointed by R0.
Value pointed by R0. Or the address pointed by R0.
Address pointed by R0, sir.
Dele, go. Address pointed by R0, yes. Dele.
Then increment the pointer R0.
Okay.
Then finally moving the value of accumulator to the address pointed by R0.
Pointed by R0. Why again and again here? Move at the rate R0 also here also, and here also we have why these two things are written again and again?
Because we are incrementing, no sir?
Okay, increment B. And increment B, what is the reason behind incrementation here? Why we are incrementing R0?
Because we have to increase the value of 55H from the location 40H to 41H, no sir, that's why.
R0 anilalo, R0 is 40. Now, with incrementation, it will be 41. How we go?
41.
Yeah, that's why now in this case, I'm moving to 41. Of the value address which is pointed by R0, that is 41 now. In this one, I'm moving the value of A to the address which is pointed by R0, that is 40. How we go? Did you understood everyone, Anna? This code. So this is, yes. We are successful. We move the value from 55 value to 40 to 41 without loop. This is without loop. Now with loop, we'll explain. So this is indirect. This is indirect. Why it is indirect? Because it is at the rate. Okay. But here you can see some register addressing mode also here. That's why this is register indirect. Now with a loop. We'll explain. Roshan. Kale Roshan. Roshan Mindu. Jujjai Bhukhu.